Hey everyone, this is Sunny Justice from It's a Crime and Shame. This is the case of Anna Walsh, who disappeared on January 1st of 2022. Here's an update about the friends speaking about Anna Walsh.
Evidence is revealed and the couple's dark past comes to light. The hopes of finding Anna alive is fading fast. So I spoke with Anna's friends, Natasha and Pamela, as their concerns grow. Watch.
What do you know about Brian?
Unfortunately, not much, because every time when we would have a conversation about Brian, it would be switched to children or brushed off.
What do you mean brushed off? How would the conversation go?
Literally switching the subject. So, and I said, Anna, if there is anything, it's okay. And she said, everything is fine.
So some of our sources that we've been talking to, some of her friends, have said that he had this note, her husband, Brian, had this no picture policy. I mean, it's even hard to find pictures of her out there when we want to remember her life and try to get answers for her. Did y'all hear anything about that? Does that surprise you, this no picture policy?
Hard to say, she was hiding, truly. But the absence of him, I understand that even in New Year's Eve, my friend said that he would not even take personal photos for between friends, that he was missing in the photos during the New Year's Eve. That he would take pictures of everybody else, but not of himself. So there must be some reasons for it. I don't want to speculate what the reason, but it is odd.
Did Anna have the type of personality that, if anything perhaps was going on, would she ever display it? Or was that against her personality?
That's what probably we felt, that absolutely nothing about personal. And also at the party, she was alone. She was not with her husband. Even if she would be a sponsor.
She never showed up to social settings
with Brian. No. That was unusual.
I have to ask you, forgive me for asking this question, but do you believe Anna is alive or do y'all believe Anna is dead now that you know what you know?
One in a million chance, that's what I would answer. Not because Pamela and I know her personally, how Anna is driven and how she's independent, she would find a way to reach out to people if something would happen to her. If the person is missing for 11 days, nowadays with the social media, with the world being connected so quickly, and with the evidences that unfortunately came up, and especially with the police reports, every day it's unfortunately looks dim and dark.
When I just saw the poster, the social media post missing, my stomach went upside down. I knew something was wrong.
So obviously we got to talk about the children, because the children are in child protective custody right now.
Yes.
You guys have spoken out about being concerned about their well-being, and you don't want them split up.
They need to be together. They need love, they need home. They need to be together. Everything what they have is frankly each other, right? And they need familiarity with the children who were interacting with them before. But we all deserve to know justice. We all deserve to know what happened to Anna, especially her children.